the commercial space business has blossomed over the past decade. The private sector is also doing a lot of work in the space arena, and a lot of individuals and startups have spent a lot of time developing space-related technology. The space projects have been dominated by government bodies until we saw ambitious company like SpaceX and Blue Origin. SpaceX is doing an incredible job with back-to-back rocket launches in the US. The company has already launched its 11th Falcon 9 rocket of the year, and there's a lot more to come. Recently, SpaceX also became the first private company to successfully launch its SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket into space. It is the first time ever that commercially developed space vehicles, owned and operated by a private entity rather than NASA, have transported humans into orbit. For the first time in history, a commercial company entrusted to carry NASA astronauts to and from the ISS has successfully taken humans to orbit and back on the world's most advanced rocket and spacecraft. No commercial company has ever achieved to complete such a mission before. SpaceX has truly become one of those names that'll stay synonymous with the US space history. In case you're wondering, there are a lot of private Indian rocket companies here too. In India, companies like Solar Industries India, Skyroot Aerospace, Godrej Space and L&T are already working with ISRO on rocket systems and other space-related technologies. You may not have heard about them unless you're heavily invested in space study, but here are some major private Indian rocket companies that are India's answer to SpaceX. Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Infinity Insight for more videos like this one? And ring the bell for more fascinating content. And there is a surprise for you all guys in this video. We have a big announcement to make. So make sure you stick around until the end of the video. It's gonna be a fun ride. The space exploration industry is a vast one and needs an inexplicable amount of money and technology to carry it forward. There are private Indian rocket companies that will push the boundaries of space exploration with ISRO. Let's begin with the Skyroot Aerospace first. Skyroot Aerospace is a Hyderabad-based aerospace manufacturing company founded in 2018. It was founded by former ISRO scientists Pawan Kumar Chandana and Naga Bharath Daka. A lot of people from the Skyroot leadership team are former ISRO employees, so they have a lot of experience and bringing the ISRO heritage, so many people have worked on rockets previously. The company is working on its Vikram range of rockets as a tribute to Dr. Vikram Sarabhai, and they're prepping to send satellites into space by mid-2021. The launch vehicles are specially crafted for the small satellite market. Built on common architecture and covering a wide range of payloads, they offer the most affordable and on-demand ride to space. Skyroot has three rockets under development. The first rocket is the base for the other two rockets. Vikram 1 is a three-stage rocket. It is 19 meters tall. It can put 225 kilograms to solar synchronous polar orbit, SSPO, and 315 kilograms to 45 degree inclination at 500 kilometers altitude. It has highly reliable solid propulsion stages with proven design heritage. Miniaturized and modern avionics. Having ultra-low shock pneumatic separation. It has the flexibility of orbital adjustment module with restart capability enables multi-orbit insertions. Skyroot claims to be very responsive. Requires minimal range infrastructure. And can be assembled and launched within 24 hours from any launch site. Vikram 2 can put 410 kg to 500 km SSPO and 520 kg to 45 degree inclination at 500 km altitude. It has the advanced cryogenic Methalox engine replaces third stage of Vikram 1. It has upper stage cryo engine with restart capability that enables multi-orbit insertions. Vikram 3 is basically an upgrade to Vikram 2, but with additional low-cost strapped on solid rocket boosters. And a bigger fairing, 580 kg to 500 km SSPO, and 720 kg to 45 degree inclination at 500 km altitude. Vikram 1 is scheduled to launch next year end, December 2021, but might get delayed due to the current situation, maybe in early 2022. They are planning to use a mobile launcher. But now since the government has announced new rules so they could use the ISRO facilities, so whether deploy the launcher from Sriharikota or from Thuthukudi, from where SSLV is supposed to launch from. Besides Vikram 1, 2 and 3, they are planning even a bigger rocket running on Methalox. That can put satellites into a geostationary orbit and be reusable. And will be announced soon. Check out their website too, the link is in description. And next is Space Wings. Space Wings is a Mumbai-based aerospace company founded by Soham Vichayar in 2019. The company is in its initial stage. They also arrange live stargazing and astrophotography event in Mumbai, India. They also create amateur rocket and launch them for data analysis of the flight of the rocket launch. We make use of some modern rocket components and software to make the model safely land back on the ground. The company is currently working on a rocket named Antariksh 1, which is a two-staged rocket. It is 17 meters tall. It has capability of carrying 120 kilograms to lower Earth orbit, 600 kilometers. Powered by liquid propellant engines, LOX and kerosene in all stages. They are also working on retro landing of stage 1. Stage 2 is expected to be upgraded to supply thrust with electrically powered rocket engine. This amazing design of their rocket is created due to the efforts of their team member and business partners. The internal part of the rocket is designed by Space Wings team, Neha Singh and others. And here is a surprise. The outer part is designed by Infinity Studios and Space Wings team. Yes. We collaborated with the Maka Infinity Studios collab with Space Wings. We designed their outer part of the rocket. You can check out on their website. It was great collaboration. Looking forward to work with them more. Antariksh 1 can take off with different sequence of engines. Depends on the location of the launch. The thrust produced by each engine is 25 kN. This may change in future. Antariksh 1 is expected to be launched in 2021 to 2022. Next is Agnikul Cosmos. Agnikul Cosmos is a Chennai-based aerospace manufacturing company founded by Srinath Ravichandran and Moin SPM. The company incubated in a IIT Madras. The company is working on a rocket named Agnibin, which is a two-staged rocket with 3D-printed engines runs on liquid oxygen and kerosene. An optional third baby stage might be available for select missions. Its height is around 18 meters. Capable of taking up to 100 kilograms to orbits around 700 kilometers high, Agnibin can access both low and high inclination orbits, and is completely mobile. It is designed for accessing more than 10 launch ports. Agnikul wants to be one of the first companies to offer affordable in-orbit launches, before branching to outer space. They are also planning for an air launch using a balloon known as Raccoon. The first stage is the balloon, and the later stages of the rocket become the next stages. Issues like carrying liquid oxygen to such high altitude, controlling top-off, boil-off and orientation, would be interesting challenges. If everything goes according to plan, it's scheduled to launch in 2022. Their main focus is on 3D printing. A lot more to come. Watch for updates on their website. Their website is really awesome. The animation showing Agnibin and its detail, step-by-step showing each stages. The way of presentation is really cool. The link to the websites is given in description. Do have a look to it. Not only this, I'll give each company's link mentioned in this video in the description. So don't forget to check it out. Now, the other company is Bellatrix Aerospace. This one's an Indian aerospace research and development company developing orbital launch vehicles, rockets, and electric propulsion systems for satellites. It's based in Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu, and was founded by Rohan M. Ganapathy and Yashas Karanam. Bellatrix is working on a rocket named Chetak, and it could be the first rocket with engines that use methane and liquid oxygen. It's a two-stage rocket and around 19 meters tall. It can put 150 kilograms to 700 kilometers SSPO, where the first stage is designed for reuse. The first stage of Chetak will use a 4-ion engines. Chetak features an all-carbon composite construction. This rocket is designed to be capable of launching multiple satellites in the same launch mission, and placing satellites in equatorial, inclined as well as polar orbits. They are planning to use a mobile launcher from Thoothukudi to launch their rocket, although it remains to be seen how it works out. Currently this rocket is on hold, but their target is to launch in between 2022 to 2023. They had plans to make a rocket called Garuda after this rocket, which will be even more powerful. But now that too is probably on hold. Bellatrix specializes in satellite propulsion. There are very few companies across the world working on such technologies. Bellatrix is working on two kinds of propulsion. One is green propulsion and other is electric propulsion. In this day and age, where environmental concerns are reaching an all-time high, green propulsion system is where they are using a chemical, but it's non-toxic and safer to handle. Bellatrix is working with the Indian Space Research Organisation, ISRO, to develop propulsion systems for them. An electrically powered spacecraft propulsion system uses electrical energy to change the velocity of a spacecraft. The propellant is ejected up to 20 times faster than from classical thrusters, and therefore the same propelling force is obtained with 20 times less propellant. They are developing two kinds of electric propulsion. One is microwave electrothermal thruster, MET, and another is Hall effect thruster. MET produces higher thrust at a lower efficiency, while Hall effect thruster produces less thrust, but at a very high efficiency. We will see a MET launch next year on an ISRO's satellite around March. Bellatrix Aerospace is a key supplier of electric propulsion systems for satellites. These thrusters mark a revolution in the field of nano and micro satellite propulsion, as the power requirement for these thrusters is relatively low. These are the companies working on developing rockets. There are many more. Now, I'm gonna talk about the company that is well known by everyone. Dhruva Space. Hyderabad-based Dhruva Space is engaged in making small platform satellites. Established by Sanjay Nikanti, it has worked with companies like Exceed Space, AMSAG, Cisco, and KPMG. It started in 2012, and now more than 8+ countries are actually working closely with this. In the year 2014, the company signed a deal with Hamsat India to develop Hamsat 2. Dhruva Space builds application-agnostic small satellite platforms. Their vision is to offer small satellites coupled with Earth stations and launch service as an integrated solution or individually as a technology solution for their prospective customers. Dhruva Space was the only India space tech firm presenting at Interplanetary Small Satellite Conference 2020. One of the papers to be presented by Dhruva Space includes Lunar Far Side Tracking and Communication Relay System, which tries to enable a communication between researchers, wherever they are, and the far side of the moon. Other presentations by Dhruva were using small satellites as an interplanetary data highway and gravitational perturbation measurements in Martian orbit. Dhruva Space is looking forward to make space technology affordable, accessible and human space exploration a common trend. Another is Pixel. Pixel, a tech company that is the brainchild of two 20-year-old student entrepreneurs, Awais Ahmed and Kshitij Khandelwal. Their vision is to build a global space tech company out of India that would contribute meaningfully towards space exploration. Their master plan to achieve this vision is threefold. 1. Build a constellation of advanced Earth imaging nanosatellites that can provide real-time remote sensing data. 2. Develop the supporting artificial intelligence, AI-backed technology to analyze the data collected by these satellites and make highly accurate data-based predictions in different sectors, such as agriculture and mining, to find effective solutions for existing problems. And, 3. Use the technology it has developed to map out resources on the Moon, Mars and the asteroid belt to contribute towards the exploration of our solar system. Pixel is the only company in the list that's set for a launch in the month of November this year. This company is planning to launch around 24 ultra-high-resolution Earth observation satellites to gather data and study agriculture, climate change, etc. The small satellite will go in a Russian launch vehicle and will focus on high-clarity satellite imagery. It would be helpful for governments and private organizations in collecting AI-powered analytical data related. They are planning to launch the second satellite by July 2021. And to have a constellation of 24 satellites to be launched in a gap of 3 to 6 months. It's an interesting concept, to say the least. And last but not the least, Irvium. This company is in initial stage. Irvium is a Sanskrit word for high speed and powerful. The name hence fits perfectly to describe a very high speed and powerful engine called the Irvium engine. Founded on August 16, 2018 in Mumbai, Irvium core focus is to do research and develop high-end technology in the field of aerospace. Irvium is building next-generation space engine and vehicles for launching satellites into orbit. While satellites are mainly used for telecommunication and Earth observation, Irvium propose more exploration of space by building galactic observatory stations. Equally challenging is building space-based transportation for goods and passengers, and Irvium is capable of addressing this with its unique, powerful and truly reusable vehicles. They have recently shared brief details of their rockets. One is SLV-1T, their first satellite launch vehicle with carrying capacity of 1,000 kg to low Earth orbit. And its launch target is 2025. Another is SLV-VT. It is reusable satellite launch vehicle with 5,000 kg carrying capacity to in synchronous orbit. And its launch target is 2027. There are many more companies like these in this field, but these are the major ones. Do follow their social media accounts to know more about them. After all, these are the SpaceX of India. Do share this video as much as possible, so that everyone also knows about India's private space companies. Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. We hope this video has given you some insight and maybe inspired you. If you liked the video, give it your thumbs up and subscribe to our channel if you have not already done so. Click on the bell to always receive notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching Infinity Insight.